have two projects, Indo-German project and JICA projects is going on. Activities is going on. But unfortunately, Tripura Motha volunteers illegally entered the office and they threatened. They use slang language to my officers, forest officers, and they try to prevent, they try to stop the development activities. It's very shameful. I want to request the Tripura Motha chairman, our Bhubagra Pradukishu Devarma, to look into this matter. It's a very shameful matter. Nowhere in the country, nowhere in the state is happening this kind of activities. Therefore, I strongly condemn this kind of activities which is committed by the Tripura Motha volunteers. Therefore, our party IPFT is observing the situation. We are calling down to dust ban on 22nd May. I will inform all the division level volunteers, our youth, our artisans, all the leaders and volunteers of our party to maintain peace and democratically we are doing the 24 hour bans. Especially will be affected, will be in the Addis area. Therefore, as you know, IPFT always organized peacefully, democratically. We never disturb anybody. Therefore, even today, I have informed my Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb. I just have a meeting with him. I also inform him that all the anti-social element is prevailing in Addis area, especially after the Addis election, that all the criminals, all this element should be stopped. And we have given a lot of FIR filed against who are involved in these activities, who have damaged our property, stolen, robbed our property. All these people, whoever he may belong, he may belong to any political party members, he may belong to IPFT, he may belong to Tripura Motha or BJP, whatever. Culprit is culprit. Those have books and FIR have launched against them, against their name, should be arrested. And CM, Chief Minister, have assured me that within 10 days, he will look this matter. If not, then IPFT will think otherwise. Because IPFT, you know, we have a still strong hold in our Addis area. We have 1,100 youth are still waiting. Therefore, I am requesting the people of Tripura, both tribal and non-tribal, to maintain peace. And I am assuring you, coming ban 22nd May, we will maintain peace. And I will inform all the volunteers not to disturb anybody, not to break the law, not to take the law in their own hand. Therefore, I request all the people of Tripura to cooperate with us. So that I think the peace and law and order will establish in Tripura. Thank you. Today, especially, Party IPFT Central Committee have decided some important issue. We had just held meeting this early morning at the residence of N.C. Devarma, and we have discussed about the present situation of Tripura. And our discussion and the point I would want to highlight today. First point, we strongly, vehemently condemn yesterday attack on our president, Honorable N.C. Devarma, and also senior minister of our state government, Sri N.C. Devarma. We really regret and condemn this regarding this incident. It was pre-planned just to give the bad name to our president, N.C. Deborah. And you all know N.C. Deborah is the senior most leader of our state and most intellectual person, learned person in our society. He has a lot of experience in his life. He also hold various office in central office, state office, and he also director of All India Radio. And his service, he go around all over India, and he have got vast knowledge. Such senior leader, especially we all people, both tribal and non-tribal, give him high regard, high respect to our N.C. Deborah. Therefore, not only IPFD party, whole our people, both tribal and non-tribal of Tripura, condemn this kind of activities, this kind of colonialism. We strongly condemn on our party. Therefore, I would like to request all the media friends to highlight this issue and to protest against this incident on 2nd May, that is Saturday, 22nd May, that is Saturday. There will be 24 hours burnt, down to dust burnt, especially in this area. Central Committee of IPFD had decided to sponsor this movement on 22nd May, Saturday, 6 a.m. to 23rd May, 6 a.m. That is 24 hours down to strike burnt, was sponsored by party IPFD. Just to condemn this kind of activities, and our party also demand to arrest all the culprit who involved during this incident. Secondly, the government of Tripura to compensate a push-pull EDC election violent. There are more than 100 houses and property was destroyed, and it was lost the property. Even the fish pond also put in the poison, and cattle, so many property was stolen and robbed by the antisocial element, so-called Tripura Motha cadres, volunteers are involved in these activities. It was reported to the police station, FIR have lost. So all this involved, those activities should be booked and be arrested. That is our party, IPFD, had demanded to the government of Tripura. And all compensation should be awarded. Those have lost the property, houses, cattle, and so many things. Third, again today, there again incident took place in Belbari area, Kumbulung area. Our honorable MLA, Dhirendra Devarma, was attacked and he's injured. And his vehicle was damaged. That also have given FIR. All the culprit involved. They are also pre-planned wise. Especially I want to mention, I've got a lot of report. The present MDC, Ganesh Deborah, he's the main leader who make incident. Today's morning incident around 11:30, I got report that some volunteers, so-called Tripura Motha volunteers, are gathered here to prevent, to stop our meeting. IPFT, we have a scheduled meeting there in Govinda Hall, but this morning, led by Ganesh Debarma, MDC, have organized to stop our meeting, and as soon as our leaders, our volunteers in the near the Govinda Hall, Kipramotha volunteers attacked them, and also they have attacked our MLA, Honorable MLA, Ganesh Debarma. Total 6 person was attacked, and they are injured and they are in the hospital. There also, really, I strongly condemn this incident. And we, IPFT, are watching the situation, observing the situation, only 2-3 months. And I always appealed to maintain peace and order, especially in this area. And also there are a lot of information we have got, and you have reported to the government also. And it is really shameful and condemnable. I was told that all the ADC village committee, which was expired last 7th May, now it is lying vacant. And unfortunately, they have violated the rule. It was informed that 7 March it was only the expire, but they have illegally nominated the village committee chairman and vice chairman and member, which was illegal. Therefore, that also we are looking very seriously. I condemn all the incident. Now I was told that all the village panchayat was occupied by them, so-called appointed chairman and vice chairman. They went forcefully, they're entering the panchayat office, and they threatened to the people, and they're blocking the development activities, Rega work, and they threatened to the village secretary, block chairman, block BSC chairman, and also BDU, and all other officials, government officials, were threatened by the Kipramotha volunteers. It's very unfortunate. And also I was informed in my forest department, we have 450 JFMC committee, Joint Forest Management Committee, which was constituted, which was formed earlier. Even there, the Kipramotha volunteer entered in the office, in the forest office, and prevent the development activities. It's very shameful. The forest department is running. It is our state government property department. Kipramotha or any volunteer have no right to enter in the forest office. You were reported from different part of the state. Since I was the forest minister, I was informed by the forester Ananjar and DFU. Many Kipramotha volunteers, they went in the forest office and try to stop our development activities.